All right, so we made it to round one. My opponent actually won the die roll and chose to draw. So that's awesome. Obviously, my deck really wants to be on the play, and I've got a really good hand to follow that up. Additionally, my opponent said that he loves my videos, so I'm good to know that there's someone out there who does. Happy about that. But in the meantime, pretty happy with this hand too. So no mulligan. I'm gonna have turn two Blood Knight. Turn three, I can either remove something with Cannonade or I can play Entity. Eh, Corpulent Corpse, okay. Against me, that's more like Crapulent Crap. It's gonna be too slow to really do enough. But it does mean that it's a turn six guy that he doesn't have to pay mana for it at that point. Does he have a way to deal with my Blood Knight? Nope, he's got a Tisus. Another card that might be too slow. We'll see. I'm threatening to win the game pretty quickly here. And we'll play a face down Entity. I have played that guy face up before as a 5-1. I don't know. I'm not sure if I've ever played it face up as a 1/5. I guess I have done that too, actually. So let's make this a little bigger so we see all of his suspend counters. There we go. Urborg Siphon Mage. Seems like a good target for my Cannonade. So let's do that. I'm sad right now that this is an entity rather than the Gaethan Raiders. If it was Raiders, obviously I would just do more damage right now. It looks like Crapulent Crap is going to do something. That is actually the card I call it. That is actually the name I use for the card in some of my more casual circles. Okay, Cutthroat Illdal, interesting. Well, my entity is gonna eat that guy. That's nice. But it is unfortunate that it's gonna make me flip my entity as a 1/5. Then we'll play Skycutter. And he's close to getting his Tisus off, which is annoying. Like, even if Corpulent Corpse isn't very good against me, it's still a one mana play of a sort against my deck, so that's problematic. What's he got for me? Death Rattle, okay. I can handle a Death Rattle, I think. So I'm gonna keep two land in my hand for any mind rot action. There's some sort of black discard two thing. I just don't remember what it is. And actually, I'm not gonna do that. There's too much of a possibility I draw a two drop and want to actually use both. So he's got Corpulent Corpse, which is a fairly okay defender here. Augur, okay. So I can't avoid doing the value play here and just taking the Augur and Auguring him. It's too likely to be the play that wins the game. So, even though it means I won't get to attack through his Corpulent Corpse, yeah, this just seems awesome. He might have something with madness, though. That would be annoying. Oh, he did actually have a mind rot in Wistful Thinking. That's kind of funny. He just hasn't drawn the mana for it. Okay, well, he's going to get to Tisis me, which is mildly annoying. His last card must be pretty good if he wanted to get rid of Wistful Thinking and Massive Ghouls. Trying to think of a reason I would want to play the land, but I guess I don't have one, so. We're going to let him Tisis me, that's annoying. It's going to put the life at 11-9. Assuming he goes for the entity. He might go for the Augur. Yep, he did go for the Augur. So 14-9. Okay, no attack. Not too surprising here. I guess I'm going to play Needle Peak, but I don't know if I need to play the Augur yet. Basically, the reason to hold it in hand would be for if I draw Empty the Warrants. The reason to play it, I guess, would be if he's playing more Wistful Thinkings. Yeah, or if he's got, like, a double blue spell. Yeah, we'll go ahead and play it. I think if I get a Warrens, I'm okay with saving up for it for a little bit. So next turn, assuming nothing changes, I can hit with Needle Peak and Entity. Okay, so he had a removal spell. So I'm a little bit ahead on the board, but not a lot. Synchronous Sliver, sure. Is he? Yeah, he didn't want to attack yet. Not too surprising. So now I kind of need to draw a flyer. Like, a Stormcloud Djinn would be really strong. Flowstone Embrace, okay. That's reasonable. Not sure what I want to do with it yet, though. I could use it with my entity. Yeah, now, I mean, obviously now I wish I had taken Fatal Attraction instead of Flowstone Embrace. Because Fatal Attraction I could just put on his Corpulent Corpse. Oh. Now we're talking. Wow. So that makes this turn a little tougher. Yeah, I guess I'm just going to play this face down and not play anything else. It's a tough choice here. Because I could play it face up and then play, like, land and play my Embrace on something. Delay. Okay, well, now it's going to come into play in three turns face up. Surprise! Gaethan Raiders. Yeah. Oh, well. If he does ever attack, I'm happy to start getting in there. Oh, and then I just draw this. Hello. Boom, 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 boom. Stormcloud Djinn with enough to make it 9-3. Yeah, seems good. Pretty happy with my 11-6 mana base right now. I guess we'll see if he has an answer. So there's the possibility that I could maybe just do 7. So that if he bounces it, I can replay it. And then I can count on my Emberwild Augur to do the last points. But yeah, he just didn't have anything. If he had maybe Venser's Diffusion, that would have mattered. But even then, I'm still in a situation where I'm ahead on the board, looking pretty good. So, what do I do here? He has Sudden Death. He's got a couple of 2/2s. Trying to figure out if Blind Phantasm is a better pick for my deck right now than what I had. Yeah, and I don't think it is. It might be that Grinning Ignis is better than Bogardan Lancer. I mean, Bogardan Lancer is better than Grinning Ignis here. Because flanking is good against his X1s. He has Augur of Skulls and Cutthroat Ildal, among probably others, but... Yeah, we're going to stick with what we have, I think. He does have a fair amount of discard. Could play Unblinking Bleb as well. Yeah, maybe we go with Bleb instead of Ignis against him, because he's got a lot of removal, and he saw multiple good morphs, so... This can worry him about morphs, maybe? Yeah, I think I like where that goes. I don't want to cut any of the X1s, because they're 2 mana. But I think I am willing to bring in Bleb instead of Ignis or Phantasm. And hey, it can be pretty sweet when you turn it face up. Especially later in the game.